This morning we offer a change of pace. Because of a number of reasons, we are recording our service on Monday afternoon, and Soul Spirit is without our bassist, Jason Melito. We're also changing up the format a bit, so I'll begin by reading the gospel. Jesus told them another parable. The kingdom of heaven is like a man who sowed good seed in his field. But while everyone was sleeping, his enemy came and sowed seeds among the wheat and went away. When the wheat sprouted and formed heads, then the weeds also appeared. The owner's servants came to him and said, "Sir, don't you sow good seed in your field? Where then did the weeds come from?" "An enemy did this," he replied. The servants asked him, "Do you want us to go and pull them up?" "No," he answered, "because while you are pulling the weeds, you may uproot the wheat with them. Let both grow together until the harvest. At that time, I will tell the harvesters, first collect the weeds and tie them in bundles to be burned. Then gather the wheat and bring it into my barn." The showman's life is a smoky bar, and the fever chase of a tiny star. It's a hotel room and a lonely wife. From what I've seen of a showman's life, nobody told me about this bar.
No mention of all the But nobody told me about this farm.
Today it appears that most of America is imprisoned in a black and white worldview. We are polarized. Those absolutely for Trump, those absolutely against Trump. Black Lives Matter versus All Lives Matter. White people enraged, people of color enraged, evangelicals with unyielding beliefs, mainline believers with an equally unyielding perspective. Psychologically, a black and white worldview is most apparent in adolescence, which begs the question whether, as a nation, we have regressed to a far less mature approach to life. Black and white thinking is either or. It's either good or bad, right or wrong. I like it or I don't like it. Buddy Miller's A Showman's Life poignantly shows us both and. The black and white mixed together, side by side, or as Jesus urges, the wheat and weeds growing together. Showman's Life, it's a smoky bar and the fevered chase of a tiny star. It's a hotel room and a lonely wife, from what I've seen. But showman's life, you see, nobody told me about this part. They told me all about the pretty girls and the wine, the money, and the good times. No mention of all the wear and tear on an old honky-tonker's heart. Well, I'm unnoted, but nobody told me about this part. In his parable, Jesus attempts to move us into a both-and worldview, where God eventually is the one who sorts it all out. But dude, we do like to play God, don't we? Seen my share of broken halos, folded wings that used to fly. They're all gone wherever they go. Broken wings that used to shine. Angels come down from the heavens. When I got serious about caring for my lawn, my goal was to create an expanse of lush green grass. No dandelions, no white clover, no thistles, no weeds. Our 1900-era Victorian home in Bloomington, Illinois, had been built on a once large property owned by a colleague of Abraham Lincoln, and it was called Clover Lawn. And so rather than accept the clover that naturally had covered our lawn for decades and decades, I spent years eradicating it, along with every dandelion, thistle, and weed I could find. Of course, we have entire industries built on de-weeding our lawns, leaving nothing but grass, which, by the way, contributes nothing to bee, butterfly, bird, or insect life. Go figure. So it is, I find, that life is often a process of unlearning as well as learning. Lately, I've been schooled by Pat Milliken, an extremely knowledgeable woman at CLC, a master naturalist and environmental educator. Pat has begun to teach me that dandelions attract bees and butterflies. Birds, especially goldfinches, eat dandelion seeds. I discovered to my chagrin that white clover is good for the soil, transferring nitrogen to the soil. It is also attractive to pollinators and a food for wildlife. Milkweed attracts monarch butterflies, which are in decline. Bees and butterflies love the flowering thistle, and birds eat their seeds. Broadleaf plantain, found naturally in almost every yard, is another nutrient accumulator for the soil. Nettles are the host for the admiral butterfly. And Joe Pye weed, a beautifully tall plant, provides a habitat for pollinators and beneficial predatory insects that control insect pests. So, as I worked for years to eliminate weeds from my lawn, I was destroying the natural habitat for bees, butterflies, birds, and helpful insects. Carl Jung points out that once we become aware, consciously aware, we are then faced with an ethical dilemma. As we become aware that we are destroying the natural habitats for non-human life, we have to decide whether we will change the way we care for the habitat of our yards or continue the destruction of non-human life. All of our environmental organizations are advocating that as homeowners, we provide some of the habitats for wildlife because of the extensive habitat life that is destroyed due to farming road to road rather than leaving edges, to housing and commercial development, and to pesticide use. Whenever it is safe to gather again, CLC will be recreating our landscape as a friendly habitat for bees, butterflies, birds, and helpful insects. If you're interested in helping out, just contact us through the church office or our website. Just like broken halos are somewhat an oxymoron, so are good weeds. There are always deeper meanings to Jesus' parable about the wheat and weeds that fertilize and enrich all of our life. One, two, three, four. She said, Andy, you're better than your past. Winked at me and drained her glass.
cross legged on a bar stool like nobody sits anymore. She said, Andy, you're taking me home. But I knew she planned to sleep alone. I carried a bed, sweep up the hair from the floor. If I loved her before she got sick, I'd never hear the end of it. She don't have the spirit for that now. We drink these drinks and laugh out loud and talk about the weekend crowd and try to ignore the elephant somehow. She said, Andy, you crack me up. Seagrams in a coffee cup, the sharecropper eyes and her hair almost all gone. When she was drunk, she made cancer jokes. She made up her own doctor notes. Surrounded by a femme, I saw she was dying alone. But I'd sing a glass of country songs and she get high and sing along. She don't have a voice to sing with now. We burn these joints in effigy and cry about what we used to be. Try to ignore the elephant somehow. Giving up my place in line, but I don't give a damn about that now. There's one thing real clear to me, no one dies with dignity. We just try to ignore the elephant somehow. We just try to ignore the elephant somehow. Just try to ignore the elephant somehow. 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 Somehow.
One of our earliest unhealthy defenses as children is called splitting. And it often continues into adulthood. Christians can see faith as wholly positive and doubt as wholly negative. God and Satan once held together spiritually in the Old Testament in sayings such as, I am the God who kills and makes alive, who wounds and heals. The Christian psyche later splits the image into Christ and Satan. Anger is seen as wholly negative, whereas, for example, anger is actually a healthy response to our boundaries being violated. In the song Elephant, we find Jason Isbell finding love, laughter, intimacy, and empathy in the midst of a woman dying of cancer. In this case, wheat among the weeds. Spiritually, psychologically, archetypally, wheat and weeds are two sides of the same coin, as are faith and doubt, love and apathy, life and death. If we live at a depth of soul and height of spirit, we get both sides of the coin simultaneously. As Luther writes in his commentary on one of the Psalms, in the midst of life, we are in death. We have to be careful what we try to pull up and remove in life. Elsewhere, Jesus warns us that if we cast out a demon dogging us in life and do not replace it with something healthy, we only create room for 8 demons to replace the one. So, for example, alcoholics who white-knuckle their way to sobriety without placing the spirit of the bottle with the spirituality of the 12 steps just end up foisting their bitterness, resentment, and misery on everyone around them. One of the strengths of Lutheranism we offer the Church Universal is that the Lutheran approach teaches us how to live with ambiguity. We become willing to live with the various shades of gray, leaving it up to God to sort out the finer points. So as Lutherans, hopefully we come to know what Leonard Cohen sings. There's a crack in everything, but that's how the light gets in. God is in the roses, the petals and the thorns, storms out on the ocean, souls who will be born, and every drop of rain that falls. Falls for those who mourn. God is in the roses and the thorns. The sun is on the cemetery. Are on the stone. There never was a place on earth that felt so much like home. We're falling like the velvet petals. We're bleeding and we're. God is in the roses and the thorns. I love you like a brother, a father and a son. It may not last forever and ever, but it never will be done. My whole world fits inside the moment I saw you be reborn. God is in the roses. That day was filled with roses. God is in the roses and the thorns. The rose is an apt metaphor for Jesus' teaching. We don't get one without the other, the rose and the thorn. So there is no healing without first being wounded. There is no Jesus Christ without the fall of Adam and Eve. How would we know man without woman and woman without man? And today we are learning of the ambiguity of masculine and feminine energies. We're being asked to live into life that exists on a continuum in so many ways. We may be finding that life right now is more than a bit confusing, but as a wise man once told me, confusion is a good thing. It's when we are in the midst of confusion that we are in the midst of letting go of old ways of thinking and living and fumbling our way to new ways. Wheat and weeds growing together, growing within us and bringing us new life. May you experience God being with you this coming week. May you remember that you are yoked to the Christ. May you open to the risk and reward of the Holy Spirit and let all things grow together. Amen.
Seen my share of broken halos, folded wings as you still fly. They're all gone wherever they go. Broken halos, you still fly. Angels come down from the heavens just to help us on our way. Don't you know? Come to teach us, then they leave us. Find some other soul to save. Save my share of broken halos. Used to.